Hello students, today we are going to start with chapter number 5 and the name of the chapter is the fundamental unit of life, right? So basically the fundamental unit of life that we are considering cell. So you have already studied about the cell in 8th standard, right? So let's recall it ki 8th standard mein aapne kya padha tha. So here the scientist Robert Hooke, which examined the thin slice of cork for the first time, and he saw that the cork resembled the structure of a honeycomb consisting of many little compartments. Like might you have all observed the honeycomb, right? So you can see in the structure of honeycomb, a hexagonal shape, little compartments will be there. Little compartments mean little boxes will be there, right? So cork is a substance which comes from the bark of tree, obviously. This was in the year 1665 when Hooke made these chance observations through a self-designed microscope. He has designed a microscope to observe the cells or the little boxes which is shown in the slice of cork. So to observe that little boxes, he has designed his self microscope, and Robert Hooke called these boxes cells. वो छोटे छोटे जो बॉक्सेस दिख रहे थे उसको उसने नेम दिया, इट कुड बी कंसिडर एज दी सेल. सो बेसिकली सेल इज़ द लैटिन वर्ड विच मीन इज लिटल रूम. सो दिस मे सीम्स टू बी वेरी स्मॉल एंड इनसिग्निफिकेंट इंसिडेंट, बट इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन द हिस्ट्री ऑफ साइंस. दिस वॉज द वेरी फर्स्ट टाइम दैट समवन हैड ऑब्जर्वड दैट लिविंग थिंग्स अपीयर टू कंसिस्ट ऑफ सेपरेट यूनिट. ये पहली बार था जब हुक ने माइक्रोस्कोप के अंडर सेल्स को जब ऑब्जर्व किया. एट दैट टाइम ही हैड ऑब्जर्व दैट लिविंग थिंग्स अपीयर्स टू कंसिस्ट ऑफ सेपरेट यूनिट्स, एंड दैट सेपरेट यूनिट्स वी आर कंसिडरिंग इट एज अ सेल. सो द यूज ऑफ द वर्ड सेल टू डिस्क्राइब दीज यूनिट्स इज बींग यूज टिल दिस डे इन बायोलॉजी. वो पहली बार किसने यूज़ किया था? रॉबर्ट हुक ने. एंड स्टिल वी आर यूजिंग दैट वर्ड सेल इन द biology, right? So now the next is, what are living organisms made up of? So all, each and every living organisms exist on this earth is made up of what, right? So that we are going to observe. So what are the living organisms made up of? So we know the answer of this question, that cell, all the living organisms having the basic structural and functional unit that we can consider is as a cell. So we know the answer of this question, but to still understand the answer, we can go through the activity. So here activity 5.1 is given over here. So as per this activity, we need to observe the onion cell, right? Here we are going to observe the onion cell. So let me explain you that first of all, how you will prepare the slide to observe the onion cell under a microscope. So you all know that slide is a slide is made up of a glass. So over that slide you have to take the onion peel. Onion peel means what? When you are going to peel out the onion, you will find a clean transparent layer over it, right? So that clean transparent layer of the onion, you have to take it out. That is considered as the skin, epidermis, right? Usko bolenge, it is the skin of the onion, or it is considered as the epidermis. Epidermis means outer layer of the onion peel, it is considered as the epidermis, right? So with the help of forceps means in Gujarati we can call it chipio, right? So with the help of that forceps, a tiny forceps will be there. With the help of it, you have to put the onion peel over the glass slide. Onion peel aapko glass slide mein leni hai. Then after putting the onion peel over the glass slide, we have to put the indicator over it, because we know that onion peel is transparent and the cell present inside the onion peel, it is also transparent. So all that transparent thing we are not able to observe under a microscope. So to provide it provide some color to cells of the onion, we need to use some of the indicators, right? Or staining agent, usko hum staining agents bhi bol sakte hain. Staining means to provide the color to the cells of the onion peel, right? Okay, so we can use the any staining agent. So we can use methylene blue over here, or any other staining agent also we can use, right? Saffron in hai, methylene blue hai. These are the staining agent which is used to provide the color to the cells of the any object, right? So here we are going to use the onion safranin as an indicator. Okay, now after adding the safranin as an indicator, we need to put a cover slip over it, right? So cover slip is a thin glass slide, or we can say a thin glass sheet, which we are going to put over the slide. So why we are putting the cover slip over it? So to remove the air bubbles, right? If there is any bubbles will be present over the slide on the onion peel, then we are only going to observe only air bubbles, right? We are not able to observe the onion cells. So to remove that air bubble, we have to put a glass slip over it and compress it. So when we are going to compress it, what happened? All the air bubbles will going to be removed out, right? Now under a microscope, our slide is ready to observe under a microscope. So as you can go through this figure, you can put the slide over here, right, and make it where fix, right? So after fixing the glass slide under a microscope, now through this eyepiece and adjusting the coarse adjustment and fine adjustment, you will able to observe the cells of the onion peel. So when you are going to observe the cells of the onion peel under a microscope, you will observe this kind of structure. Aap kuch is tarike ka structure dekh paoge, and that is the cells of the onion peel, right? So on the basis of this activity, we can give the answer of this question is, what are the living organism is made up of? So we can say that the living organism is made up of the basic functional and structural unit that we are calling it cell.